Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll explain how easy it is to create and configure the Syncfusion React spreadsheet using the Create React App command. The spreadsheet, also known as the React Excel Viewer, is a feature-rich component for organizing and analyzing data in a tabular format. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic features like selection, editing, formatting, resizing, applying formula, importing, and exporting Excel documents. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I create the app using the Create React App toolchain, use VS Code as the editor, and show the output in the Chrome browser. Now, I'll create a new application in the command prompt, using the npx create react app command, and provide the app name, My React App. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Then navigate to the desired location and run this example using the npm start command. I can edit the app.tsx page to render the spreadsheet. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file. I also remove the styles from the app.css file and import the Bootstrap 5 theme CSS styles to apply them to the spreadsheet component. Then, I install the package using the command npm install at Syncfusion EJ2 React spreadsheet. When the package is installed, I import the spreadsheet component from the EJ2 React spreadsheet package and add the spreadsheet component tag. Let me run this application. See, a spreadsheet is rendered with no records. I can click any cell and start editing now. The spreadsheet has other features like selection, sorting, filtering, formula, etc., which I will explain in detail in my upcoming videos. Now I'll show you how to bind data to the spreadsheet. First, add the sheets directive tag, which is used to add multiple sheet collections. Here I'm going to show only one sheet, so I'll add one sheet directive tag. In the illustration, you can see the result of adding a single sheet directive. To bind data to different ranges, add the ranges directive tag. Now I'm going to bind data to a single range, so I add one range directive tag. You can see how the cell range from A1 to D4 is filled with data using the range directive. I have already added the data.js file, which has local data, default data, with fields, customer name, model, color, payment mode, delivery date, and amount. In the app.tsx file, I import the default data from data.js file and assign this object to the data source property. Check now, the spreadsheet is rendered with the local data. I can adjust the columns to fit the content. Finally, I will show you how to open an existing file and save the modified file in the spreadsheet component. To import the existing file in a spreadsheet, enable the Allow Open property and assign the Syncfusion service URL using the Open URL property. In the same way, enable the Allow Save property and assign the service URL to the Save URL property to export the spreadsheet. Check now in the File tab, I click the Open option and choose the desired file. The selected file data will be shown in the spreadsheet. Before saving, I will apply background to a range. Now, I save this file using the Save option in the File tab. Choose the format as XLSX and name the file Sample Modified. Click Save. You can see the downloaded Excel file at the bottom of the browser page. Let me open this file and show you the data. Notice that the file is in protected view. To edit the file, click the Enable Editing option. The applied background color is exported in the Excel file. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion React spreadsheet component using the Create React App command and a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.